Good morning, OUAZ. And welcome back to another edition of Spirit Life. Today is our Christmas version of Spirit Life. What?
What's on your face?
I told you, it's No Shave November. Isn't it luscious?
I have so many questions.
No time. We need to get the show going.
But...
I'm Chris. And she's Dez.
It's not even real looking.
And we are OUAZ TV. Check it, check it. Don't forget to register for your spring classes.
Did your beard just move?
Don't be silly. Visit the Odawa every Tuesday and Thursday from 10 to 3 p.m. It's first come, first serve.
It's crooked.
If these times don't work for you, you can schedule a time with your Odawa advisor. There is still time to enter the Fang Shop T-shirt design contest.
It moved again.
All current OUAZ students are invited to submit one entry into the contest.
Can you just take it off? It's so distracting.
The OUAZ student body will vote on the winning design during finals week.
I'm not kidding. I can't even focus right now.
The winning artist will receive a $100 gift card for the Fang Shop and a free t-shirt featuring their design.
I can't work under these conditions.
The winning design will be produced and sold in the OUAZ Fan Shop. Submit your designs to OUAZ Fangshop at ottawa.edu by November 30th. Hey, Dez! I have to step away to do some important beard stuff, but I found someone to take my place.
Important beard stuff? What does that even mean? Hey, Fang! Oh, thank goodness, finally a real professional joins me. While we wait for Chris to come back, why don't we play some lightning questions? Texting or talking? Favorite day of the week? Would you rather speak every language in the world or speak to animals? Favorite holiday? First celebrity crush? Favorite food in the calf? Favorite Christmas song? You. What's one thing you want to do today?
Fang stole my beard!
Athletics.
Sports!
I feel so betrayed. The men's basketball team plays Justice College here in the Faith Arena tomorrow at 7 p.m.
The men's basketball team also plays on Saturday at 2 p.m. here in Faith Arena against Segu.
That's it for OUAZ TV for 2023.
We will see everyone in 2024.
Have a great 12 days of Christmas, Spirit Life.
And good luck in the rest of the semester.
Have a great winter break.
Have a fantastic day.
Yeah, that's mine.
All right, I'm so glad we got to show them. Thank you, OUAZ TV. There's a lot of people to thank because this is the last one of the semester. Chris, Jessica, you guys back there, I appreciate you guys, the worship band. Everybody who has helped set up, Abby, Mario, everybody, I really appreciate it. I can't do this alone, so I really appreciate this. All right, we're going to try the chaos here. So, Mario, come on up and help me. If you could put up that first slide for the 12 days of Christmas, we're going to attempt to do this. I need a lot of participation here. So here's how we're going to do this. Instead of us doing one at a time, I've asked, we have that first slide. Or not. Well, I've asked JT. You guys know JT? Producer? Give him a hand. He's going to come down. Can we get him on that mic there? Is that live? Chef? Produced? All right. So JT's going to be our baseline. He's going to be our number one. If the slides don't work, we're just going to have to wing it. We're just going to, because I worked too hard, and I really want to hear your voices today. So that's why we're going to do it either way. So the first one, on the first day of Christmas, on the first day of Christmas, OUAZ gave to me, JT is the baseline, is going to sing A Building Called Veritas Hall. Okay? So, JT, can you do that line?
You should have picked someone who's better at singing.
No, it doesn't matter. Singing doesn't matter. We just wanted to put you in a leadership role and make sure that you are...
Right, we should.
Okay, go ahead.
A building called Veritas Hall.
How about that? How about that? The other baseline group that we need is number five. So if you've ever heard the song Five Golden Rings, like that kind of just holds us all together. So if you've taught a PGD workshop and you are faculty or staff, I need you right down here in the middle. Right down here, there's more of you than that. Don't make me call you out. Don't make me call you out. Nice.
Step. Okay.
Can you do the next slide? Can you do the next slide? So we can just see all of them. Okay, there we go. So five is going to be five PGD workshops. We can't call them just PGDs because Dr. Tyner would have a fit because they're PGD workshops. The whole day. Anyway, all right, so you guys want to roll with that? Want to try that real quick? Let me hear it. We'll get better, right? We'll get better as we go. We'll get better. Okay. All right, so that's the one in the five. So we're just going to go down the line this way as we do that. But for number two, if you haven't done so already, please say hello to our guest for Spirit Life Christmas, Fang. So Fang's going to go over here by volleyball, and this section right here is going to be number two. So you guys are going to be two Fang howls, and then you're going to go, oh, like howl. Like that, okay? I don't know if that was a howl, but that's the best I could do right now. I'm a little stressed. I have a bad heart, so don't. Anyway. So, two Fang howls. All right, you guys want to practice real quick? Two. Got it? We won't have to practice it. We won't practice all of it. You guys are going to be four crazy professors. Volleyball. All right, next slide, let's go.
You ready?
All right, everybody can chime in. On the first day of Christmas, he gave to me a building called Barrett's Oz Hall. All right, Fang, hold on the candy. Let's hold on when we get to your part. All right, on the second, can we switch a song? On the second day of
to Fang House.
Oh! This is going a lot better than I thought it would. All right. On the third day of Christmas, gave to me three stiff glasses.
Two big
houses.
And
a building called Veritas Hall. All right, I got to think we're going to get better. I got to think we're going to get better. Fourth day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
we're facing a time when, for Christmas, Christ is left out. He's missing. During all the fanfare and the food and the fellowship and the time to spend with family and all the fun that you're going to have, it's easy to miss Christ at Christmas. In fact, it's not unique. Like the first Christmas, there were many people who missed Christ at Christmas. And I just want to talk about a couple of them really quick. The first one is the innkeeper that missed Christ at Christmas. In Luke 2:7, it says that Mary gave birth to her firstborn son and laid him in a manger and then wrapped him in cloths and laid him in a manger. Why? Because there was no room for him at the inn. If the innkeeper only knew that this baby that was going to be born in his hotel was the son of the living God, trust me, they would have found a room. They would have found a room. If the innkeeper only knew the King of Kings and Lord of Lords was going to be built, going to be born at that hotel, he would have sold mugs and bumper stickers and t-shirts and concessions. We're told that a decree went out then from Caesar Augustus that everybody had to go back to their own land because they needed to take a census. They needed to count the people. So they all went back. It caused a lot of traffic and jammed up all the hotels, just like today. See, the innkeeper had no room at the inn, and the question is, do you have room? Do you have space to give Jesus his due? During the census, there were many people just going from place to place, and the innkeeper missed Jesus that day. In fact, there were more animals at Jesus' birth than people. See, the innkeeper was all right, business was good, the hotel was full, but Jesus was missing. Don't miss Jesus this Christmas. Can you have a birthday party for someone and lose the person its birthday is for? Either you treat him like it's his party, or you probably need to call it something different. Second person who missed Christ on Christmas was King Herod. King Herod was king back then, and the Bible says he heard that there was supposed to be a king of the Jews born. And he goes, well, I'm the king of the Jews. What do you mean they're looking, these wise men are looking for a king of the Jews? See, Herod didn't have room for two kings. One of the biggest ways you miss Jesus is you don't want him to rule your life. One of the ways you miss Jesus is you're troubled by Herod that the fact that he wants to be king in your life. See, King Herod didn't want anybody to interfere with his life. I'm king. I'm in charge of my life. People don't want Jesus to interfere in their lives, their careers, their money, their power, their personalities, their ambitions, or their plans. See, we've kind of sanitized Christmas or cleaned it up. It's sweet, it's cute, it's melodious, it's got mistletoe, and those are all great things, but that first Christmas, it wasn't so. Herod gave a decree that all the boys under 2 years old be slaughtered, be killed. See, when Jesus shows up and demands to be king and is rejected, there's trouble. Today, a lot of the reasons that our world has trouble is because we've rejected Jesus. Chaos, confusion, division are just a few of those results. See, Jesus can be around us, that's okay. He can be in the vicinity, that's okay. He can't be on the throne, he can't be telling me what to do with my life. Guys, if Jesus can't overrule you, you're not celebrating Christmas. If Jesus can't tell you yes, if Jesus can't tell you no when you're thinking yes, that's probably a better example. If Jesus can't tell you no when you're thinking yes, you're not celebrating Christmas. You're celebrating you, like it's your birthday. Herod didn't want the competition, but the Bible says Jesus is the King of Kings and he's the Lord of Lords and he's in charge. So if you want to really celebrate Christmas this year, if you really want to give Jesus a present, tell him he's your king. Tell him he's in charge of your life. The last group that missed Jesus was the church people. The Bible says Herod asked them, hey, where's this Jesus going to be born? And they told him in a little town called Bethlehem that was predicted over 700 years before that time. But you know what? They knew he was going to be born in Bethlehem, and they knew the wise men were going there, but they didn't go. The church people didn't go to Bethlehem. The wise men did. What I'm trying to say in a roundabout way is just because you know Bible stories or you know some of the Bible, if Jesus doesn't change your life, this book is really of no value to you. It's what he is. He came he came, they didn't understand why Jesus came. Why Jesus came to be born, and then, like Gracie was talking about, eventually come to die. They didn't understand why. Do you understand why? Do you understand why Jesus, why this is a big deal, why Christmas is a big deal? He didn't come to make you feel better. He didn't come to shame you. He didn't come to inspire you. The Bible's clear. He came to deal with sin and provide salvation. That's it. That's the whole story of Christmas. And if you don't understand that, please go see somebody, because that's the real meaning of Christmas. See, the question I want to ask you today is, are you missing Christ this Christmas, or is it just a holiday? And if it's just a holiday, that's fine. One part of the nativity scene that people really get wrong, or your scene might have it at home, you probably have a Mary, a Joseph, a baby Jesus, three wise men, and three shepherds. But three wise men weren't at his birth, the Bible says. They came later when he was a toddler, which means he was probably about 2 years old. So they saw the star on the day of his birth, and it probably took him months to get to where he was. I can't even get up for church sometimes on Sunday. These guys crossed continents to go see Jesus. They figured he was worth it. They figured he was worth the journey. They understood that Jesus was the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and he's on the throne, and he's worthy to be praised. So don't leave Christ out of Christmas. In fact, make a big deal about him. Put him where he belongs in your life. After all, it's his birthday. Let him sit as ruler of your life, calling the shots. Since my heart surgery this April, I have to go every month and give blood, and they take blood, like 3 vials of blood out of me every month, and go check for all different things. One of the things they check for is cholesterol. And I've tried to make myself more intelligent on some of the things they're checking for, but from what I know about cholesterol, it causes plaque. And that plaque can block my arteries. And if my arteries are blocked, the blood can't flow through. And if the blood can't flow through, I could have a heart attack. And if I have a heart attack, I could die. Merry Christmas. You see, you and I have plaque built up in our souls. And it's called sin. And sin leads to death. And then they told me about these balloons they can put into your arteries, and they blow up your arteries, and so the blood can flow again. Jesus has that balloon for you. Jesus can open your soul and heal you. Romans 3:23 says the wages of sin is death. What you deserve is death. But the gift of God, Jesus being born, Jesus dying for you, that gift is eternal life. If I were you, I'd make a big deal about Jesus this Christmas, because his blood was shed for you. Because Jesus still has saving power. He still has victory power. He still has freedom power for you. Make a big deal about Christmas this year, guys. About Jesus. Because Jesus is the reason for the season. Let me pray for you. Lord, thanks. Thank you so much that we can celebrate and have a whole bunch of fun, but man, I pray that there's some of the students here I know we've talked, and they're on the cusp of really making a decision, Lord. And I just pray this Christmas that they would dig in and see who Jesus really is, because he's good. Thank you so much for this plan of salvation, that we can have eternal life. We love you and thank you in your name. Amen. All right, one more song. Let's stand, and then we will load that one up. And it's a sing-along, so kind of like Disney sing, like sing that out. Once that song is
y'all
done,
are going to want to sing, so let's stand. Let's stand. You guys got that cue yet?
This Christmas, fireside.